Greetings. Welcome. I do apologize, you guys, for earlier. So I had to wait so I could have a moment to come back and to redo the last live for you guys. I discovered that there was no sound. So the good thing about me is I have an energy and a memory like an elephant. So essentially, I'm going to be able to repeat everything that I said. I love it. So, but I just wanted to come back and apologize to you all. I tried to actually upload it. This is when I discovered that I didn't put the sound. I had on a different headset when I was doing the last live. And so I was like, oh, so now I know, like with this one particular headset I was using, it wasn't picking up sound. Okay. So I do apologize for that inconvenience. Essentially, I was on here, you guys, like almost a whole hour, and you guys were not even able to hear me. But because I was moving about, I couldn't see if anybody was putting any comments, you know, so I wouldn't have known because I was actually moving about. So I didn't see if anybody had come in to say like, hey, we can't hear you. Hey, hello. Right. So I didn't know, guys. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. I'm like, oh, you know, but the good thing is I did catch it. So I'm like, I'm glad that I catched it because, you know, it gives me the opportunity as soon as I have a moment to go back and essentially provide this information that I feel like is going to be helpful for some of you. Okay. In the title, we have Ddbk, okay, and it stands for Daily Dose of Bad Karma, okay? So we're on this whole trend of where I'm telling you guys as divine beings, you guys are receiving DDD, okay? You're getting some type of daily dose of Dharma, okay? If you are trying to be the best version of yourself, you're working on yourself, you're healing, you're ascending, you're transforming, you know what I'm saying? Not saying that you're perfect, but you're a divine being and you have surrendered to your journey, okay? Your ancestors and guides are helping you to be able to on a daily basis, okay? Not saying everything is perfect and everything goes exactly like you want, but daily you're receiving some type of good karma, some type of dharma, and your guides are ensuring it, okay? But likewise, they're confirming to you all, they don't want you to think much about it, but they are confirming to you all that no matter how things appear, you can bet your bottom dollar that the individuals that has been behind fuck shit with you, no matter if they are karmics or not, whether they're black witches or not, no matter what their get down was, if they did some toxic fucked up shit to you, you can bet your bottom dollar. If you've called judgment and they've watched and have seen this, they're wanting you to know that yes, at some point accumulation does catch up on both sides. There is an accumulation of dharma that catches up, but likewise, there's an accumulation of bad karma that equally catches up. So these individuals are receiving a daily dose of bad karma. Now, the title particularly is about my story. Okay, so that last live that I did here, you guys couldn't hear, right? And so I was giving you guys, they wanted me to share the examples to make it tangible, okay? Because they brought some things back to remembrance for me in terms of, look, this is why. But people don't connect the dots, see? And so essentially, divine beings, they're wanting you to know, like, it doesn't matter at the end of the day, okay? Whether people are trying to scurry about covering it up, trying to act like they don't know that it's bad karma, or even if they do know, or, you know, whatever, that essentially this is happening, okay? It happens. I was in a position the last time DM1 and I were together, okay, in a relationship. My guides brought some things back to remembrance in terms of like what happened to him And then they kind of showed me what the karmics were doing. Also, meeting my karmic family as well as his other karmics. Okay. You guys have heard me tell you guys this time after time in my story. It's karmics. Sorry, I'm still laughing to you. Okay. Get serious, Brandy. Get serious. Okay. It's funny now. I'm laughing now. But anyway, okay. Karmics. It was my karmic family. And then he, my karmic family was his karmics. Go figure. But more than that, he had his own karmics outside of my family. He was swarmed with the motherfuckers. Still is probably shit, unless he done ran. Shit, he ran. He probably running scared now. Check. My guides brought back to me something that happened to him. Okay. The second time me and DM1 got back together, I had done another level of healing. I wasn't quite where I am now, but I had done another level of healing. And the guides, they're like, okay, well, let's see what this motherfucker gonna do. Okay. So as is typical when we are in our, shadow energy, unawakened and still highly, attached to karmics, you don't see straight. You're still under the influence of that spell work, as well as their head games and all of that other shit. So DM1, his baby mother and the women that took care of his children are karmics, whether he has fully faced it or not. Okay. His father, his story is similar to mine. See, and this is what divines have to catch up to realize. I have a karmic family and so does he. But, he didn't, when we, I'm telling y'all, when we locked into this shit, man, can't nobody tell us shit. We have to learn the hard way like everybody else. Because that's just the name of the game. We're hardwired. That's the name of the game. The only way out is through. The only way out is ascension. And so when we refuse that, we stay in the illusion. Okay. So DM1 had karmic feminine energies long before he met me. Okay. He told me about one of the women he was with for the longest of time that basically took care of his kids. And he would say to me, I mean, I had to learn later that, people in narcissistic energy, they go about saying the same shit to everybody they get with, right? But I've learned this. But there's some truth. Everything he said wasn't a lie. That's always the case with a narc, right? So he told me that, when he was telling me the story of this woman that he was with for a long time, she eventually relocated somewhere else, a whole nother state. That first and foremost, he said that she had cheated on him with one of his friends. Then he said that she was all obsessed with him and wanted to marry him and was planning out their wedding and songs and all sorts of shit and, blah, blah, blah. And I said, okay, over time he told me this and I'm like, well, shit, why the motherfucker? I'm like, well, I was confused. I'm like, well, I'm not understanding. Then how come it ain't? And they lived happily ever after, bitch. Like, what the fuck? Then he was like, well, they had problems. I guess he went to therapy with her. He said he eventually cheated. So he shared the story about them. But what he didn't know is that obsession. See, I started figuring something out early on about that dynamic. That's just one karmic that I'm mentioning in the story and what ramifications that he ended up, DM1 absorbed and didn't know it. It's kind of trippy and how it was all projected over onto me. But this is why a lot of people is under the gun now, man. So she is one of them that was secretly manipulating and strategizing and guiding him in the wrong direction intentionally because she is obsessed with him. Yes. Even though she would try to portray herself to be like somebody that was moving on and had a boyfriend here and there, DM1 didn't get it. Okay. No woman is going to be hanging around your life, okay, still taking care of your children, and worse yet, allowing you to use their shit unless there's some type of, you know what I'm saying, some type of secret, you know, desire to stay connected or to hopefully to keep you stuck or, you know what I'm saying, nobody, ain't no woman finna do that unless, okay, so she, you know, DM1 has a tendency, what I do know about him, he can be quiet, you know what I'm saying, but he's the King of Swords, dude. He's the King of Swords. So what I know that took place with him, even though I know he talked a whole lot of shit about me, I'm aware of all the fuck shit of all of these motherfuckers, by the way. But when you piss him off, he's the King of Swords. So even though he was probably talking a whole lot of shit about me, right? Lying and shit, but talking a whole lot of shit about me, to these hoes, right? When they piss him off, when he, you know, go through situations where he either find out they still a hoe, they still hoeing and gonna always be a hoe, or he finds out that, you know, they're still in, they gonna always be a thief. Or, you know what I'm saying? Like he find out some shit or they just get on his nerves one too many times, right? When this happens with DM1, he sometimes tell the truth. When he's mad, often you're going to find a truth. So he probably says some shit to these women in his anger. Like, well, fuck you, because he's good for that. He could have been like, fuck you. And then was like, I want, you know what I'm saying? I love Divine Feminine anyway. I love her anyway. I was only just over here. Like, he could say some hurtful shit, right? And, like, or they could have, you know what I'm saying? And karmic women, you know, karmic individuals will tolerate pretty much any and everything. This is why they stick around for so long, right? But then in their envy and jealousy towards me, what Divine Masculine did not understand, DM1, I should say, what he did not understand was that this kind of journey, it's not that they just gonna fuck with him. When they discovered and they did know who he was and they knew who I was before I did, and this is why it was a conspiracy. So when they discover this, and then if he say some shit out the side of his neck when he pissed, because he will, okay? He will. He did. Then they commenced to try to send toxic energy to me. This is where they really went wrong. But they, you know, started trying to create chaos and conflict and blockages for me because they didn't like Divine, DM1 could have been like, they could have caught him looking at some pictures or shit. You know what I'm saying? They be knowing. So they became obsessed. Some of them tried to be me, copycat me, look like me, sound like me, talk like me. Oh, she doing this? I'm going to do this. Oh, she saying this? I'm going to say this. Oh, she got a platform. I'm going to make me one. Oh, she, you know, so, you know what I'm saying? They commenced to do that. And then they commenced to harass me. Okay. He was a part of it at some point. But some of these people was doing all kinds of shit beyond what he knew and had been doing it. Okay. Dizzy motherfuckers. going to church on Sunday and giving her a fucking respiratory treatment on Monday to the kids. Okay. So I told y'all it wasn't just my family. He had many. So now, then they started doing spell work on me. They were doing spell work on him. He didn't know this. Okay. So now here is where the daily dose come in. Because somebody's going to say, where is the daily dose? I'm about to tell you something because my guys took me back to some stuff. Whoa. So now, right, I want to go back to, let's go back to the first time we broke up. So they're going to take me back. Okay. We go back to the first time we broke up and then when we got back together. Whoa. So when we first broke up, guess what happened? This was a ramification and nobody saw it. They actually tried to project it onto me. One of the ramifications of what these people were doing, as well as DM1, they were sending distorted energy to my physicality. They were sending distorted energy, death magic, death rituals, you know, chaos, be sick, whatever the crazy shit did. They were sending it, right? Guess what happened to DM1? DM1 ended up getting a huge tumor on the left side of his face. People tried to blame that on me. But let me tell you what was really behind. It was a ramification of DM1, first and foremost, bad mouthing me. He went wrong with that. Bad mouthing me to his karmic horse and my family. There was the ramification. Oh, you're going to speak against the divine with these karmics? Watch. You're going to wish this on a divine being out of this disillusionment you all are in? Watch. So that was a part of the ramification for DM1. But more than that, it was people sending rituals. And what he didn't understand was that because I was aligning and healing, okay, I was always taking full, you know, opportunity to heal and transform from what I was going through. So because I was in that kind of a path, then it was being ricocheted. On a twin flame journey, if you are connecting to karmic individuals and participating and sending spell work to the counterpart, you eat it. You receive it. It's crazy. So if you're sitting back giving whores money to do ritual, to do rituals, thinking it's coming back to DM1. It's like, oh, they wanted her sick. Now you're sick. You're connected to them. So that's your karma. You're absorbing it. Okay. So my guys let me see it. They wanted me to be reminded of this to tell those of you that are on a similar path, like this is a real thing. Okay. When I reconnected with DM1 the first time and when he started telling me about it, I was like, what the hell? And he said, I don't know. I was like, what the hell? And these individuals were doing rituals. Yes. His ramifications showed up. If they were trying to attack my physicality, then somebody's physicality had to get hit. Okay. And, you know, I later discovered, you know, when we were still dating back then, like then he had some weird lump showing up on his back and shit. I was like, I remember, I was like, what is this? And these people tried to put it on me. Why? Because first and foremost, I'm not a coward. I'm not afraid to be authentic. I'm not afraid to be me. I'm not hiding. I'm not trying to act like I'm godly, but yet secretly doing shit. They try to use and scapegoat religion as a means to try to project their fuck shit on me. But it was them. The entire time. These women, see, DM1 didn't understand that just as much as he was had his addictions and obsessions, like these women were playing on to that, okay? So, but he didn't want to see was that I don't care if they were, you know, I don't care how these people walk around. They can work at the hospital, bitch. I don't care if they got clothes that's looking all fucking humble and shit. I don't care if they at church, but bitch. Like, he didn't want to accept. That it was always these people. DM1's life was fucked up long before he met me. And this is why. He had women that was obsessed. He said it. He himself said it. But see, he didn't get, he thought he was all, you know, that ego was all fluffy. See, that narcissism. Thought it was on some other shit. Thought it was like they was in love and yeah, not quite there. Not quite. He didn't get it. It's like, nah, dude, you fucked up because these hoes and your homies. That's more fucked up than you. Because he had homies that's more fucked up than him. Okay? Karmics. More fucked up than him. That was secretly jealous of him too. What DM1 didn't understand is people are jealous of this journey. They be mad. They be pissed. And in DM1's case, you know, by his own admission, you know, he knew he did shit to these people, to these women. He told me. Okay. Now, I know that chances are it's some lies in some of the shit, but he said, first and foremost, the one, the motherfucker that was all obsessed, wanted to marry him, shit, took care of his kids. The one went to the other state and shit. Whoop. Okay. He said she cheated on him with his friend. He said he later cheated with somebody at work. Okay. Like in their whole little get down and dynamic. Okay. Like what went down, what brought something to an, you know, an end and yada, yada. So these people are karmic. They like DM1 being a whore. So even when he wouldn't necessarily deal with them, these people would do spells and rituals and all sorts of stuff to send lust energy to him because lust is his downfall. Okay. Whether it is sex or money. So, and they did that. That's their vengeance against him. To keep him distracted in life, never able to heal and grow, always needing to start over. They wanted him stuck. His parents wanted him stuck. His parents was willing to sell him out to the highest bidding whore that would be willing to take care of them too. As is my family. They didn't give a fuck. They didn't give a fuck. Whether it's toxic or not, bitch. They got money. Don't give a fuck. You don't got to like them and love them. They got money, motherfucker. Oh, shit. I know that as a matter of fact, based on some conversations I had with his father. So, now, he didn't, you know, their daily dose, you know, shit starts to go wrong. So first things first. So he got this tumor on his face. It had nothing to do with me. Ooh, she's of the devil. No, they're the devil. You can go to church all you want. But if you're interfering in motherfuckers' lives and doing weird shit, you are the devil. Okay? Man, anyway, so I was an easy target. I don't give a fuck though. I had gotten past that. I knew I would be supported and honored because I knew that that wasn't me. I knew it wasn't my energy. So they could say and do all they want. I knew that at some point. I'm like, yeah, they can do that. Uh-huh. And they fence, just watch. Just wait for it. I was like, wait for it. So that was the first ramification, okay? I'm trying to show you guys about the Ddbk. Of divines when they don't ascend and when they attach themselves to karmics. Okay. Now, after that, okay, so we had gotten back together, right? Well, so now all these things look like happenstance. So this is why people don't always connect it. Not long after we got together, him and his father at that time had an old car that was a roommate of his roommate's car of his father. It was old and beat up and raggedy, but I mean, it ran. Okay. It was able to get them basically to and fro, you know what I'm saying? Close proximity. At that time, DM1's father was taking him to work and stuff. He was going to work at Precision Opinion. And by the way, I know about you, Precision Opinion holes and your involvement. Just thought I'd add that in there. I know who you are. Now, so, well, guess what happened, y'all? Ddbk. The car stopped. There, you know, the dad was taking them to work. The car stopped in the middle of the street. It was a hot, blazing hot day. Just stopped, man. And yeah, on the surface, it looks like, well, it was bound to happen. People don't connect it, though. Find it ironic. We have to catch the pattern. Like, start watching the pattern of things. It'll show you something, I promise you. It'll show you. So it's like, damn, why every time? Because it was some bad karma DM1 was receiving because he was still up to fuck shit. So my guys in the universe was like, okay, we're going to have fun. Still up to it. Okay. So that, you know, they had to push it in the sun. Then they had to like junk it for some, you know, a little bit of money because it was essentially dead and they couldn't do much with it anyway and yada, yada. So that was Ddbk. Now here's more. You know, one time me and DM1 was hanging out. This is, you know, we had barely just got back together and I was trying to take things slow. And I was like, okay, you know, I was like, you're going to come over, you're going to play Scrabble, you're going to hang out and eat snacks and make shit, right? So, because I wasn't playing. He hated this part, by the way. He hated that I wasn't going to have sex right away. But, you know, so he had came and so we were hanging out playing Scrabble. I think it was when we were playing Scrabble or it could have been another date. But I was just simply being like my normal loving kind self, pure intent. I had an extra pair of wireless earbuds. Okay. And I had did a healing session on him, a Reiki session. And he was like, okay, like he felt all relaxed and better. I was like, okay, cool, whoa, right? And so I gave him this extra pair of wireless earbuds. Guess what happened the next day? Ddbk. Ddbk. Well, I'm gonna tell y'all what happened. Here's why. He was still toxic. He was collaborating with my family behind my back. On top of the other horse. Okay. So guess what happens? He calls me the next day in a panic. He was like, hey, I'm going to do it like he, let me see. Can I do his voice? Let me see. I don't think I can do his voice. His voice is too deep. I'm trying to see if I can do it. He was like, hey, babe, hey. I can't do his voice. He was like, I'm in pain.
He was panicked. He's like, I'm in pain. I was like, what happened? What happened? He was like, the earbuds you gave me, it got stuck in my ear and it hurts. And I tried to get it out. It hurts. It's stuck. I can't get it out. I was like, okay. He was like, I need you to come. I was like, okay, cool. So I went and picked him up. And I think we had to go to urgent care or something like that. Because he had tried to push it in. Apparently, let me tell you why this is karma. Because he was talking to horse. My guys and source was like, how dare you? Now you're finna pay for it. So he was doing all this sneaky shit. You know what I'm saying? Collabing with my family and his other whores on some earbuds that I gave him out of the kindness of my heart, being sincere and loving and all of that stuff that he, you know what I'm saying? So my guys is like, okay, uh-huh. I picked him up. We went to the urgent care. You know, they had to like use a surgical thing to get it out of his ear. And so that was another example of daily dose of bad karma when divines are not awakening and ascending and doing fuck shit and connecting to karmics. Okay. That's another example, okay? Now, another example of Ddbk is one time he had me to come pick him up and to take him to get his haircut, right? He was like, I need a haircut, woo, 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 right? But he was always planning and, uh-oh, what the heck? What did I do? Oh, sorry. Sorry. Bear with me, you guys. I'm sorry about that. I know it froze up here. I'm sorry about that. Bear with me. Okay, now, as I was saying, so another example of the daily dose of bad karma that happens for folks when they're in this toxic, fucked up energy is stuff like that, okay? That people just look at as happenstance because things that are occurrence of everyday life, you know? So, of course, it can come off as, you know, something that's just normal, but if we, you know, look at it and pay attention to the events and the timelines and things of that nature when these things are happening, then we see like there is possibly a connection. So DM1 was absorbing the karmic's energies, okay? Any rituals that were being done, anything he was participating in with these people towards me was going to him. So essentially, if people was wanting my car to break down and wanting, you know, out of their envy and jealousy, this is why their cars were breaking down. And this is why, you know what I'm saying, they were getting sick and so forth. It's because they were putting out that energy towards me. Okay. And so the universe was like, okay, you know, these people obviously haven't learned. So this is going to be the little things that continues to start to happen on a daily basis. Okay. Now, so the next thing that started to happen was, like I said, before I started, you know, stalling here, DM1 wanted to get a haircut and he, you know, asked for me to take him. So I took him to get the haircut and he was like, it was the worst haircut in the world. Okay. He felt like the whoever had cut his hair had butchered him something awful. Okay. He was just upset. He wouldn't even go to work the next day because he felt like his whole hair was fucked up. Okay. And again, it's because people were putting out distorted energy towards me, whether it was he was doing it and his hoes were doing it, okay, towards my physicality, my vehicle, my appearance. So they started reaping. He took so much pride in that. Then the universe was like, you want to constantly attack somebody or your whores are attacking Divine Feminine's hair. Okay, or whatever the fuck. So we're going to fuck with yours. You're going to go and sit in a chair and she's going to butcher the hell out of your shit. And so this is, you know, the universe is just simply sharing this divine beings, because you won't always see this stuff up close and personal. And more often than not, people try to happenstance this stuff because they don't want to face the realities that, you know, certain things are happening because they were toxic and negative to other people. And you can just bet your bottom dollar. They do receive, especially if you're, like I said, a divine that is on a healing path, a loving heart. And, you know, people in their envy and jealousy and need to compete, need to win at all costs. DM1, you know, Vegas is the cesspool of dark witches. Okay. This is what I discovered. So he was always, you know what I'm saying, fucking with these types. It's a cesspool, you know, of dark witches, people who are do anything for a buck. Basically, okay, I'll do this ritual on your person. You know, it's like all these sick, demented, or fear-controlled minds feel like they have to reduce themselves to stuff like that. The stuff that we do on our brains on a divine path is to rewire that subconscious so we can ascend, okay, so that we can heal, so that we can get ourselves out of certain, you know, patterns and attachments and addictions and ways. But that stuff is not meant to try to manipulate that of another. Okay. And, you know, people who indulge in that, you know, something's not right with them. Okay. And yet they try to project it onto divines because, like I said, most of these people, you know, be religious folks or people that try to have an appearance of godliness and try to claim divine beings like myself are of the devil and this and that. And it's like, it doesn't even make sense. You know, when we really look back and sit back and think about it, it's like, but you're the one doing toxic shit. So how is this motherfucker of the devil? You're the one manipulating and lying and conniving and stealing and hoeing. But this one is of the devil. You're the one trying to interfere in a grown motherfucker's life. But they of the devil. Like, no, come on. No, you are of the devil. The devil being earth. earthbound, earthly, worldly. Addictions and attachments and habits to the 3D, and willing to do things, any and everything, for this 3D reality. That's the devil. Willing to do a ritual, willing to sell your soul, willing to sell out your own, willing to steal, willing to be fraudulent. Okay, that's the devil. So people need to stop lying. Stop perpetrating. Okay, so this is the stuff these people start to receive, their daily dose. It comes in small versions and it gets bigger and bigger and bigger over time. And I thought that I would share that because that's your vindication. Your guides are going to start letting you guys know daily about your daily dose of Dharma because they prefer you to focus there. But they'll also reveal to you the daily dose of bad karma for anybody. And I do mean anybody who was willingly doing fuck shit to you. Okay? Wow, and as I said that, I looked up at my clock and it said 11, it said 111, 111, 111. So it's confirming my message that I am on point, okay? So anyway, I had another moment to where I can come back and reiterate my particular story, okay? Now I do need to mention the karmics maybe a little bit more in terms of what they receive. You know, I did mention DM1s. But the karmics too, like for an example, the things my family went through was a part of their karma for trying to fuck with me. Okay. So, you know, but people didn't connect the dots. I told you guys about how for a long time, my oldest niece and my great nephew were getting into weird accidents and stuff all the time. And that's because my sister was sending that distorted energy to me and my son. So it was being reiterated to what she held near and dear. Okay. This was the daily dose of bad karma. She was incessant upon trying to send distorted energy to me and my son. The universe of my guys was redirecting it. Okay. How dare you put that energy out? What you put out, you will eventually feel. So they kept, you know, for a while, they're getting into car accidents, weird shit. Okay. Because she was sending it to me. Okay. Likewise with my mother, like a lot of the things that happened with my family, they never connected the dots. That is because they set up and invested in rituals and spell work, lies and treachery to try to intervene and interfere in my life, to try to ruin my life, to try to control my life. My mother was sick and plagued the way she was because of her lifetime of being connected to this kind of dark shit, right? While pretending like she wasn't. So people started dying around her. Chances are it was the people that she was doing shit with. They whole ass went first, okay, for trying it. They whole ass went first. Then, you know what I'm saying? She took a hit. She wanted my foundation to be rocked. She wanted me dead. She wanted me sick and burdened and broken down. You know what I'm saying? So that's why her body was that way. And people don't get it. That's how far gone folks are. They don't get it. Like, you're absorbing. You're wishing ill on another. You're sending out the evil eye. You're paying for rituals. You're partnering up with your delusional daughter. And you think you're not going to be affected? Especially on a divine being? This is why everybody was fucked up. This is why all the shit was starting to fucking, you know what I'm saying? Not just because she's old. I know people that was her age frame and it wasn't nowhere near in that kind of shape. So It was karma. It was it manifesting, just like it takes momentum. It takes time for us to get our daily dose of dharma. And so it is with the daily dose of bad karma. So it takes time. The momentum builds up and then there's an execution. It starts to become something daily executed because there's been a buildup and a momentum of investing in something karmic. So eventually the ramifications get released by the multitudes. The momentum has been built. So now there's a sense of a daily dose. Okay, like, damn, what the hell? Because you were consistent and incessant upon hiring people, bullying people, stalking people, doing spell work, doing this and doing that, and now you're reaping it. In the case of my mom, her body took the hit hard because that's what happens. She did rituals on her own mother. You know what I'm saying? She got a nice, I'll just say she absorbed everything she put out. See, this is the reality. She absorbed it. So you want to practice some rituals? Universe said. You want to practice some rituals? You want to do some weird shit on your mother? You want to do some real shit on your middle daughter because you're jealous? Always have been? Your body is going to absorb it. And your end is going to be that you wished for her. That's how it goes. It starts to build. It builds over time, sometimes years. Okay? And like I said, with my older sister, you know, she did that mirror magic. They participated in that mirror magic to essentially try to switch energy. In other words, to try to have my energy or signature to be upon them or her so she can be seen in the light that is mine. And so that I would be seen in the light that is hers. So I call judgment on that severity. Nice, a nice little special. I called it. I saw it. I found it. I revoked it. I reversed it. And I called it. Judgment. Whoop ass. Ass whooping. Told my grandmother. I said, for even trying, whoop her ass. I sure did. I said, for even trying. How dare she? I said, for even going there. For even thinking of it, whoop her ass. I told my grandmother. I said, don't let up. Not on now. I'm one of them. For even going there. So I revoked it. I said, oh, okay. Well, so a part of my sister's ramifications was very unique. See, a lot of shit was planned out for a long time. Her incessant desire to try to ruin me and wanting to be me and envy and jealousy of my son and envy and jealousy of my relationship with my son, sending that distortion, it hit her firstborn and her first grandson. Yep. I look back, my guides took me back to when there was this constant, like I would hear about, there was all these accidents, you know, these weird accidents my niece at that time, okay, kept getting into. They didn't want me to have transportation. They wanted me to be this and that, all this stuff. So the universe like, really? Okay. All right. It's going to hit what you take pride in then. It is going to hit what you hold near and dear to. How dare you? You trying to take divine feminine and her son, which, like I said, is a divine masculine. My son happens to be a divine masculine. So that's what you thought? You trying to cause accidents and shit? That's what you thought, huh? That's what you thought? You don't get to do that. So Ddbk, this was, and people weren't connecting it, see? And this went on. There was different things that was happening to my sister the whole time. Because like I told y'all, she knew before I knew. So when I first got out here, like I told y'all, like she's, man. One time she ended up getting sick and had to go in the hospital. Why? Why is this? Why? Wasn't me. She was sending that distorted energy to me. Another time, hear me out. Another time when I had, one of the last times that I had went to her house, when I went to stay with her, when I and I found out like why they kept doing this. So this is like a trip to me. I was like, oh, I see how the secret witch coven worked. But so the thing was, right, when I went back this last time, whoa, she was getting Ddbk and didn't know it. See, this is what I'm trying to tell people. Oh, you can bet your bottom dollar they get shit. And the more they get shit, do shit, it accumulates and it gets worse. Especially when the divines ascend. That's why they're scurrying around now. I did a message earlier on YouTube. They're scared. They're saying, we don't have time. You got to hurry up or some shit like these motherfuckers. But anyway, so when I had went back the last time, whoa, she was so full of jealousy, man. This is crazy. So overran by all of the shit she had been practicing in, the secret hidden addictions that she didn't want people to know, man. That she covered it good and plenty. She did. She did. People were fooled because she had spells on motherfuckers. She had spells on all they bitch asses. All they asses. Ah. That's how she was doing shit. I even think she was doing spells like on her friends, y'all. I do. She had a friend that, whether she wanted to ever admit this or not, she was jealous of this friend. Because this was one of the friends that went to college, you know, and kind of had made something of her life early on. And, you know what I'm saying? She was jealous. So I really believe that she put a spell on her friend to like start having hardships and shit like that. And to like have to come to her so she can feel elevated and better about herself. It's sick, man. I think she was putting spells on her friends, putting spells on, you know, people to obsess over her. You know what I'm saying? But then so she can show up like the hero, but she was putting spells on them anyway to begin with. Sick. It's sick. So my goodness. So she was reaping though. Okay. She had been doing this shit. The last time that I went to her house, she looked at me with such envy and hate and jealousy. Right? She hated that how I looked, or she hated, you know what I'm saying, my eyes and, you know, whatever. She wanted people to say about her eyes what they say about mine, and just sick. And so she was sending distorted energy. Her eyes swole up like golf balls one day when I was there. And let me tell you something. It wasn't no pollen around, honey. It wasn't like it was super flared up or none of that at that particular time. Her eyes swole up like golf balls because she was doing the fuck shit then. Okay. And that was a part of her reaping daily dose. The more she did over time. Okay. Like I told you guys, karmics self-destruct. Eventually, it comes to their ultimate demise. Okay. if these individuals, you know, don't follow source and their spirit guides and, you know what I'm saying? That eventually, like everything else in life, right? So, yeah. I feel like my guides wanted me to share these actual events and things, you know, and make it plain. These are a series of things, and I know that there are so many more, okay, that these folks received. For an example, I think all of my family members had coronavirus, most of them anyway, right? Me and my son, no. I think they were wishing it on us. I think they were trying, you know, hoping and praying and trying to do weird, you know, all sorts of shit. And because of that, they get it. Right? And I can go on and on. You know, some of them were creating profiles and platforms. And I believe that because of the fraudulent shit that they were doing with my shit, and for cyber stalking and trying to shut my shit down, then their shit ended up getting banned and blocked over and over again in different arenas. Okay. And so that's another example of Ddbk. If you're trying to attack someone else's stuff, eventually that is going to come back to you. So if you have a social media, then yours is going to eventually get fucking assaulted if that's what you're doing. If you're attacking somebody's finances, then your finances is going to eventually get attacked. If you're sending chaos and conflict to someone's connections and homes and surroundings, then you are going to get the chaos. You see what I'm saying? If you're trying to wish homelessness on someone, then chances are you are going to eventually be receiving that homelessness. If that was the rituals that you were doing or the word curses that someone was doing, their DDBK is that it makes its way eventually back to them or whatever they take pride in. Okay. So like I said, DM1 had to go to the hospital, get that earbud stuck out of his ear, He got a horrible haircut because he's vain. His pride is in his appearance. Okay, and uses that to do fuck shit and perhaps was talking about me and his dizzy horrors about my appearance or my hair. And that's why he got fucked up. Okay. His car, him and his dad at that time, you know what I'm saying? Being jealous, you know, that I had a car at the time. Or whatever, wishing ill. So that's why they bitch asses, you know what I'm saying? That car got stuck in the middle of the street in the hot. Oh, shit. You heard me? Tried to embarrass me. See, listen to what I'm saying. When people put out all this energy, so they went about gathering people, getting people in the theater to come against me, rally against me. You know, gossiping, saying shit about me, right? Well, guess what ends up happening to them? And they can't, you know, these people can't handle the same shit happening to them. They did all of that, but they can't handle when the tables get turned. It's like now they're in the hot seat. People are gossiping about them. People are talking about them. But this is the same energy, an investment that they put out towards me. Daily dose of bad karma. All right, guys. Oh, how much time I got left now before I gotta go on to part two. Next thing I need to do for the day. Getting on the good foot. Oh, bloomy bloom is on the good foot. Got things I'm going to take care of here. All right, you guys. So anyway, I hope this served. I share my journey as a part of my own ascension, a part of my own alchemy, but also part of my soul's path to make it plain for the collective that I'm here to help in some kind of way, to bring you all true to life practical situations and experiences as examples of
everything that we talk about in readings and in teachings to show you all the connection past the theory, the connection past the reading, that in the 3D, this stuff actually do play out. But more often than not, it is hidden. It's disguised. Okay. But the reality is that more often than not, it is a direct connection to the things that individuals did to you. Okay. All right. I send you guys love and light if you're in love and light. And namaste.